Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will show you the best way to remove entities from a many-to-many association. But before we proceed, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any new Hibernate tip videos. I was asked the question for today's video in the comments on one of my previous articles. Philip asked, could you explain how to remove an entry from a many-to-many association? I had to do that, and the solution I found doesn't seem to be very clever. I'm sure there's a best practice for that. Philip is absolutely right. Working with a many-to-many association is not as easy as it seems. It presents a bunch of pitfalls that might slow down your application or cause the removal of too many records and data inconsistencies. Here are a few best practices you need to follow to avoid these pitfalls. You should map the association to a set. You should not use CascadeType.REMOVE. You should provide utility methods to add entities to and to remove them from a bidirectional association. And you need to clean up all associations if you remove the entity that doesn't own the association. Let's take a quick look at all four rules. Best practice number one. Use a set instead of a list. Mapping a many-to-many association to a list might seem like the most intuitive approach. But as I showed in a previous article, Hibernate removes association entries very inefficiently if you map it as a list. Instead of deleting the removed association, it first removes all entries from the association table and then adds the remaining ones. That's obviously not the most effective approach. You can avoid it by mapping your many-to-many association to a set. As you can see in the log, Hibernate now only removes the expected record from the database. If you want to learn more about the mapping of a too-many association, you should read my article How to Choose the Most Efficient Data Type for Too-Many Associations. You can find a link to it in the video description. Best practice number two. Don't use CascadeType.REMOVE. Using CascadeType.REMOVE on a many-to-many association removes more entities than you probably expect. Hibernate removes all associated entities, even if they are associated with other entities. Let's say you model a many-to-many association using CascadeType.REMOVE between your author and book entity. If you then remove an author who wrote a book on her own and co-authored a second book, Hibernate removes both books when you delete the author. And it gets even worse if you also activate CascadeType.REMOVE on the book author association. Hibernate would then cascade the remove operation until it removed all associated author and book entities. This can easily remove a huge part of your database. I explained the pitfalls of CascadeType.REMOVE in much more details in my article Why You Should Avoid CascadeType.REMOVE for Too Many Associations and What to Do Instead. I'll add a link to it to the video description. Best practice number three. Provide utility methods for bidirectional associations. You need to make sure to always update both ends of the association. To make that a little bit easier, it's a general best practice to provide utility methods that add entities to and remove them from the association. You then just need to call these methods in your business code instead of implementing these two steps over and over again. Best practice number four. Clean up associations when removing a referencing entity. A bidirectional association mapping consists of an owning and a referencing part. The owning part defines the association, and the referencing part reuses the existing mapping. For a many-to-many association, both parts might seem identical, but they are handled differently if you remove an entity. If you remove an entity that owns the association, Hibernate also removes all its associations. But it doesn't do that if you delete an entity that references the entity. You then need to remove all associations yourself before you can remove the entity. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!